That turned out to be a perfectly nice movie, but it was a movie about an utterly false issue, how the American economy was going to be taken over by this new giant from the Orient, Japan, which of course turned out to be, within 3 or 4 years, Japanese economy was in utter collapse and the banking system was bankrupt. So the fear that Japan was taking over the world turned out to be not really one of the great fears of our time. So the movie had a certain redundancy, I think, but... But it was fun to do, and I always enjoyed working with Phil, and not so much with Sean. But I had a good time with Phil, who else was in it? Oh yes, Wesley Snipes. Yes, come a long way from being this kid in Bad. Now he was a big star, but he did a good job. Very straightforward guy. The only amusing thing that I can think of in that was that. We had several long sequences where. Sean and Wesley Snipes are driving at night, and because we had to accommodate Sean Connery, we couldn't do what I would have done under other circumstances, which is just put him in a car and go off driving at night and film him. We had to do it in a studio with the rear projection and all that. So we would go off and shoot rear projection of where we were going to do it. It was fun to do that. It was fun to do the sort of old-time stuff that I very seldom got a chance to do, so I enjoyed that. We filmed... what they would see out the back, and we filmed what they would see out the front. We'd filmed what they would see out one side and the other side. And then when we turned around and looked at them, I took projectors instead of lights, and I projected the light that they saw that way back onto their faces, as in fact it would show on their faces. And it worked wonderfully once you synced up the shutters so that they were always open at the same time. It turned out to be a marvelous way to light them and totally effective and convincing of driving by at night, you know, because there would be a flash of this and a flash of that and there would be patterns on their face. It was wonderful. But it began to evoke some sort of response in Sean Connery. It was making him sick to his stomach, and he couldn't. It was as if, what is it that? As if he was being attacked by some sort of disease, and he kept saying he couldn't do it. He couldn't have this happening because he was. And I said, "This is ridiculous. Look, here's Wesley Snipes sitting next to you." And I said, "Wesley, what is it? Is it all right to you?" He said, "No, it's just like the IRT. It's just like traveling the subway in New York. He's all right to me." And Sean couldn't do it and couldn't keep him on. And then finally, it got to be a huge brouhaha, and they brought in the agents and huge people and started saying, and I said, "Look, come on, I just made this worse. Great, come on." And then they brought in a doctor, and he said that Sean was suffering from something called photophobia, which I took to mean fear of cinematographers. And finally we had to stop. I mean, they wouldn't, and fortunately we'd gotten, by sort of shooting while arguing, we'd gotten into most of it, but I couldn't do it anymore. But it turns out it's a wonderful way to do that part of rear projection. I mean, looking back out the window, we had regular rear projection. But on their faces, instead of lighting them solidly with some sort of silly light, we just lit them with, in fact, what the light was coming, and we did it with projectors rather than I would change the lenses on the projectors. Most projectors have a kind of zoom lens sort of thing, and I would change size of the lens was depending on how I wanted to shoot them. And it works out wonderfully if you have the time and the money to go and make those shots the night before and have them processed, and you can set up projectors on either side of the cab or the police car, in this case, what they were doing. But anyway, it brought on something called photophobia, and never did it again. I don't mean to denigrate these movies, these studio movies I did, but they're not necessarily filled with wonderful, innovative inventions of cinematography. They weren't meant to be. They were meant to be big and satisfying studio movies, although I'm very fond of that, and I have a couple of times done it since then, projected, lit people with projectors. We have to be very careful about syncing up the projectors with the shutter of your camera, or you'll get, obviously, just blankness, because your shutter will be open and theirs is closed. But if you sync it all up, it works wonderfully.